I Love Soul TV. This is without a doubt the biggest thing we've ever done. We're here live in Los Angeles at Power 106.
A lot of people been through here, from Pac to Biggie.
Exclusive for the whole of the UK and the whole wide world, in fact. So just keep it locked.
I keep telling y'all the show's worldwide. We've been sending CDs and DVDs around the world on the internet, whatever, for the past 15, 20 years. We actually got Raj here from LoveSoul.tv.
Right.
We're gonna put you on the mic a little bit later and make sure your accent is real and you didn't pick it up on YouTube, man. It's gotta be real, man. It's gotta be real. It's took a long time for the Eagle. It came down here, man. How you doing, brother?
I'm all right, man. No reason to complain, man.
Hey,
feeling privileged right now to be here.
No problem, man. First of all, who are you? What do you do?
Introduce yourself.
My name's Raj LoveSoul. I'm a DJ from the UK. I'm out here with my man DJ Friction from Def Jam in the UK.
Okay.
So he's the producer, so say what's up.
What's up, man?
Okay.
DJ Friction, Def Jam in the UK.
Yeah, he's from Def Jam in the UK, so he's a beat producer, and we're just out here at the music conference, etc., just doing our thing. But in the UK, we're the after-party DJs for Russell Peters, and we have our own online TV station, thanks to you guys, actually.
Why is that? What's that?
You guys were the first guys that were putting freestyles and whatever on the internet. This is pre-YouTube, so pre the technology giving it you for free. So I remember seeing Exhibit, and I remember seeing RZA. Like, the key thing here is that YouTube allow everybody to put up videos.
Right.
Everybody's a director, whatever. Anybody can get a little snap bit. You guys were probably, I'm assuming, paying for it to be.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Yeah. That's the thing.
Paying for all that bandwidth and stuff. And you know, oh, yeah. I wanted to kind of say on the record that we appreciate that.
Oh, thank you, man.
What we found as a way of connecting with our fans more in the UK. We take this high definition camcorder with us, and we capture as much as we can. Now, you guys, our objective here tonight, my objective is to introduce you all to the UK let people know what you guys have been doing, because obviously you guys are 6,000 miles away,
right?
And there might be people on my little island that don't know who you are.
Little island, huh? And the accent is real, man. You didn't pick this up somewhere in South Central. You are from the UK, right?
Yeah, I use this accent to pick up chicks.
It's nice, man. It's nice.
How you doing?
It's not working on me, I'm asking if it's working.
I love the accent,
women,
man.
You do your countrymen proud.
Hey, what's the first hip hop record to have the most impact in the UK? You know what I mean?
I remember sneaking in somewhere and hearing Cream, and Cream just destroyed the scene. Like when Wu-Tang dropped that.
Yeah.
I remember ODB, Shimmy Shimmy Ya.
Yeah.
I remember when people were handing out Can't Knock the Hustle CDs, the J CD, just like a promo CD.
Yeah.
So you'd be in the club, and I remember this was like 96, I think they were handing that CD out. I grew up in Manchester, I'm in London now, but in Manchester they'd have these little rooms with the curtains pulled all over the windows.
Right.
Before the police came, they'd have people that would take turns to stand by the window before the police came. And I remember they were handing out these CDs real quick, and then someone pulled up outside and everyone just grabbed their last copy of it.
Right.
I still got that original copy of that CD. So the East Coast had a lot of responsibility in terms of breaking through and doing that. But then also, I mean, I remember being given a tape, a Snoop tape, that was like copied off a copy, off a copy, off a copy.
Mm-hmm.
And that was in the early 90s. Snoop, Ice-T, Colors,
oh,
America's
okay.
Most Wanted. These were important tapes that got passed around.
Huh. Who's the biggest cat right now in the UK, in your opinion? Biggest, let me like three of the top MCs out
MC.
There.
I'd say MC-wise, I mean, I'm feeling Kano. Kano's definitely hot.
Okay.
Kalashnikov, Dizzy Rascal. Dizzy Rascal does a lot of work out here with Bombi and UGK and them. But there's a lot of our artists who are actually collaborating with you. You heard of Estelle, right?
Yeah, oh yeah,
so
Estelle, sure.
Estelle's doing her thing, when she's doing that Kanye collabo and the stuff that she's signed up with John Legend, so
right.
Much respect to her as well. She's actually in Santa Monica in the next couple of days.
What?
Estelle? Yeah, I'll give you an email and you
she
guys...
She didn't call you, dude.
All right,
you
Estelle,
guys aren't
call
cool
me.
Anymore, I guess.
In the UK, I want to shout out my partner in crime, Vic from Love Soul, the other DJ. Abs, Rishi, OG Muggs, what up? Thank you for putting us on, we appreciate it. Billy the Kid, Russell Peters, that's it.
Russell Peters.
That's it.
Alright.
Make sure you log on to that.
LoveSoul.tv. We're gonna be posting up a whole bunch of footage.
No, LoveSoul.co.uk, right?
That's the other site. LoveSoul.tv getting mad more hits, but we appreciate you.
Mad more hits.
Alright, world famous, let's go. Yes, on the fly, world famous wake up show, international.
Yeah.
Born and raised in the valley of San Fernando, with big dreams of copying me a Lambo, a high school vandal, making money from scandals. Cause man, I've been trying to get signed, but yo, I can't though. Psych, I lied, that was the front, pal. I've been signed for like a couple of months now. I got some nice subwoofers up in the trunk, blah. He got signed to Ruthless, what, how?